Namaste everyone, I am Satish Menon, an astrologer, spiritual speaker and a life guide. Friends, if you were to ask me which is one of the most crucial months in 2020, given the present circumstances, my answer for this year would be September 2020. Three extremely significant planetary changes are going to take place in and towards the end of September 2020. Change number one. On September 13th, Jupiter would be again in direct motion. It had gone into retrograde or backward motion from May 15th this year. Change number 2. On September 23rd, Rahu Ketu changed their sign from Gemini and Sagittarius to Taurus and Scorpio respectively. Change number 3. On September 29th, Saturn would again go in direct motion. Remember, it had gone into retrograde or backward motion from May 11th this year. Amazing, isn't it? So many changes within such short span of time. But out of all these changes, I feel the most significant one would be the change of Rahu and Ketu into the signs Taurus and Scorpio respectively. Remember, this is a change that has come after 18 years. And it will take Rahu and Ketu 18 months to move from one sign to another. So they will remain in these signs for the next 18 months. Because September is a period of so many changes, in my video on how Saturn affects India 2020, which I had released in March this very year, I had mentioned how September would be a very crucial month to end these all ongoing happenings that are taking place in the world with very high probability. Let's take a look.
It's downward motion, 4 degrees, 3 degrees, 2 degrees, finally 1 degree, where the retrograde motion stops. This takes place on September 29th. From there on, Saturn again starts moving in direct motion. Interestingly, September 29th is also the time when Rahu and Ketu will change the signs and the entire effect of coronavirus as a danger will totally vanish during that time in all probability.
You see, the basis of these predictions were the planetary changes that I mentioned earlier. Friends, if you have watched my previous videos, I have always presented my points with examples and evidences from the past. We are again to go back in time and explore how Rahu and Ketu in Taurus and Scorpio have operated in the past before and bring those learnings for us in the future. Stay connected and see it for yourself. September 23rd, 2020, Rahu enters Taurus, or Taurus or Vrishabha is owned by Venus or Shukra. Shukracharya is the teacher or guru of Rahu. And Rahu is of course very glad to be there in the Guru's house. Importantly for us, Shukracharya is also known as the creator of Mrita Sanjeevani, that is a cure to bring even the dead to life. In that sense, it refers to curing, healing and implementation of medicines that can cure diseases. Ketu itself is entering into own sign Scorpio, the natural 8th house or Ashtam Sthan of the zodiac, associated with research, unearthing, bringing out something new, transformation, etc. will take place due to Ketu. Add to that, Rahu will aspect the Virgo sign, the natural house for diseases or Roga Sthan. This change, my friends, is the one that augurs very well for vaccine development and implementation. Medicines that can transform the state of fear and loss that major diseases can bring. Am I saying it just like that? No. History is proof. Let us rewind our time a bit to understand what exactly happened 18 years back when Rahu Ketu visited Taurus and Scorpio. The year was 2002. 2002, meningococcal C conjugate vaccine got introduced. Meningococcemia can cause disseminated intravascular coagulation, that is DIC, or the inappropriate clotting of blood within the vessels. As per WHO, in two decades, in the African belt, approximately 100,000 deaths had taken place. So, the vaccine getting introduced in 2002 was very, very crucial. Rewinding 18 years back, we are in the year 1982-83. 83, Hepatitis B vaccine got introduced. Also, measles mumps vaccine got introduced. Measles is a highly contagious, serious disease caused by a virus. Again, as per WHO, it caused an estimated 2.6 million deaths each year. Measles vaccination resulted in a 73% drop in measles death in the past two decades. 1982, Pneumovax vaccine was introduced for pneumococcal disease. Rewinding again, friends, we are going back 18 years again, 1964. Roughly 1964 to 66, Rahu stayed in Taurus. 1966, the oral polio vaccine was introduced. Polio, as we know, mainly affects children under 5 years of age and can lead to irreversible paralysis. And it had a breakthrough development that year through a vaccine. Taking back time again, another 18 years, let's visit 1947-48. 1947, the International Tuberculosis Campaign started. That was a major implementation phase. 1948, pertussis, or also known as whooping cough. As per CDC, annually over 1,60,000 deaths occur due to pertussis. The first combined vaccine for tetanus, diphtheria and pertussis actually became available from that year onwards. Okay, one more trip back, 18 years again, 1927 to 28. 1927, cholera vaccine got introduced. That was a major breakthrough by itself again. And 1928, the Health Committee of the League of Nations then adopted BCG as a recommended tuberculosis vaccine. So friends, isn't it amazing to note that every time these karmic planets Rahu and Ketu have entered Taurus and Scorpio respectively, very, very significant medical developments, especially vaccines, have come out for public. It doesn't mean that during other times medicine development hasn't happened. But again, even during those times, they have had significant aspects from Rahu and Ketu from other locations in the zodiac belt. Friends, let us hope and pray that like every other time in history, this Rahu-Ketu transit introduces us to the vaccine, to the cure we are all desperately waiting for, and liberates this world from the shackles of a very bad cycle. Do share and spread this video of hope and positivity amongst your friends and contacts. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and do let me know in the comments box below. Anyone interested in knowing how this Rahu Ketu transit will affect you personally, then check out my previous video right here or also in the link given in the description box below. We'll see you with another interesting study very soon. Till then, take care. Thank you.